Hi, it's Paul. Today I'm going to talk about storing information in an array. Let's take a look at our parking lot system that we have. Here we've got, we keep track of how many cars are in the lot, and we've got a running daily total. But we don't have any way of keeping track of that daily total. So we need to put some more features into our logic. What we're going to do is we're going to move this daily total into an array, and we make the array big enough to hold each day of the month, and then we'll worry about resetting the month later. But for now, we just want to move that daily total into an array. I've added two buttons down at the bottom here. One says save total and the other is reset. Okay, let's go look at our tags first. I need to add two tags here. The first one is, I'm going to call it monthly. And that is going to be I'm going to make that an int. But I want more than just one integer. I want one for every day of the month. So I'll click on the ellipse here. And over here I can set a dimension. So I'm going to put 31 for 31 days. And click OK. Now notice it says it's an integer with a dimension of 31. Second one I want is a position. And that's also an int. And I'm going to use that to reference where my position is in this array for when I save. Okay, go to the logic. Now I'm going to add a couple of rungs here. In the first one, I'm going to have my save, this save button. So I put an input. That's my save. And that save is going to do a couple things. I want it to take this information and save it in the array. And then I want to increment the position so that I know where to save next time. And lastly, I want to reset my this daily number. So I'll clear that guy out. Right now it says 5. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to move the information from C2.acc into my array. My array is called, let me click on this down arrow. I want monthly. And I'll click down and I'm going to take the first position. So it's going to move into monthly. And I'm not going to take the first position. I'm going to tell it the position using my other tag. So I'm going to move my whatever's in this counter 2 ACC into that array. Next thing I have to do when I push that button is I need to do an add. So my source A, that's my position. My source B, I'm going to add 1. And my destination is position. And I want the move to happen before the add. Okay, it's going to move that information into the array. And then it's going to increase that position by 1 so that next time it moves into the next position in the array. And then I want to reset. I want to reset counter 2. Okay. I move the information out of that counter into my array. I increase the position in the array, so next time I put it into the next position, and I reset that counter. Now in this next run, I need to do one more thing here. if I just use this as a regular input, when I push this button here, when I push the button, as long as I hold my finger on it, it's going to keep incrementing this add instruction. So I need to change this to a one shot. Oops, that's wrong. Let me just add an element ONS for one shot. Okay, regular input, except it's one shot, which means it'll only send its output one time each time it goes hot. In my next one, I want my input for my reset. And I have to be careful here because in factory I/O, when I go to drivers, notice my reset is hot. So that's a normally closed switch in factory I/O. So instead of a regular input, I want to use a normally closed input to counter that. So that's my reset. And my reset's going to do two things. It's going to do, first I want to move. And here I'm going to move a zero into position. That resets my position in my array back to zero when I hit this reset button. And the second thing I want to do is I want to clear that array. And to clear the entire array, I'm going to use a fill command, FLL. So my source is a zero. My destination is my monthly. Click this guy. Monthly, and I'm going to start at position zero. And my length needs to be 31, so I fill the entire array. My second button, my reset button, is going to clear my position back to zero, and it's going to clear out that entire array. So all of my data recording is going to be cleared out. My first button, my save button, takes my daily totals, puts in the array, increases the position in the array for next time, and it clears out this counter, resets it back to zero. Let's see if it works. I'm back online, reconnect factory I/O. Okay, I've got zeros in my cars and lot, my daily total. Let's take a look at my tags. Here's my position. And if I go to monitor tags, right now it says my position is 1. I want that at 0. If I open my array, my monthly, I don't have any values in my array. So first thing I'm going to do is hit this reset button to get that position back to 0. There. Now my position is at 0. That means the first time I do a save, it's going to save the information in the zero position of the monthly array. Let's add some cars. One leaves, and two more leave. And let's say that's my daily total. I've got 6 cars that came in today. When I hit save, okay, that put that guy back to 0. That put the 6 over here in my array, and my position increased to 1. So I'm going to add some more cars from the next day. Okay, the next day I have 4 cars. I'm going to hit save again. Again, my daily total goes back to 0. In my array, in the second position, now I've got a 4. And my position is increased to 2. So next time I hit save, it'll put that value in this two position, monthly two. Well, let's add one more car and we'll hit save. Now I get a one in that next position. So that's working with array, and we have to use several commands that might be new to you to make this work. First, we use move a couple times because we can move a zero into a location to reset that location. So here I'm moving the value in the counter into that array. So I use a move command to move the value that I want to record into the array. Here I use a move command just to reset the position when I want to reset it. I'll hit reset now. I'll see how that works. Okay, here I've got my values in the array 641. When I hit reset, those all went to zero, and down here my position went to zero. So everything got reset. I wiped out all my information. Okay, I'm using the move command in a few different ways. One is to save my information, the other is just to reset something. I'm using an add just so I can increment where my position is. And then here I'm using the fill command because I could have used the move command, but to do that, I would have had to move zero into every one of these locations individually. And to do that, I'd have to use my position incrementing to know which position to go into, and it's just kind of awkward. So I use the fill command, and I say to fill starting at monthly zero and fill 31 times, which fills my entire array. And that's all I need for that. So that's a really good way to save information that's produced in your logic. You could be saving a time, you could be saving a temperature. In this case, we're saving the number of cars per day. So whatever information you want to save, you can do it by moving into an array, and then you can change the position in the array by using some sort of counter or count up or a math instruction to increment where your position is. Okay, thanks for watching. Talk to you later.